number 458, Seek Ye First the Kingdom of God.
Reading from the letter to the Colossians. As you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, continue to live your lives in Him, rooted and built up in Him and established in the faith, just as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving. See to it that no one takes you captive through philosophy and empty deceit, according to human tradition, according to the elemental spirits of the universe, and not according to Christ. For in Him the whole fullness of deity dwells bodily, and you have come to fullness in Him, who is the head of every ruler and authority. In Him also you were circumcised with the spiritual circumcision, by putting off the body of the flesh in the circumcision of Christ, when you were buried with Him in baptism. You were also raised with Him through faith in the power of God, who raised him from the dead. And you were dead in trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh. God made you alive together with him when he forgave all your trespasses, erasing the record that stood against you with its legal demands. He set these aside, nailing it to the cross. He disarmed the rulers and authorities and made a public example of them, triumphing over them in it. Therefore, do not let anyone condemn you in matters of food and drink or of observing festivals, new moons or Sabbaths. These are only a shadow of what is to come, but the substance belongs to Christ. Do not let anyone disqualify you, insisting on self-abasement and worship of angels, dwelling on visions, puffed up without cause or the human way of thinking, and not holding fast to the head, from whom the whole body, nourished and held together by its ligaments and sinews, grew with a growth that is from God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm reading comes from Psalms, chapter 85. I'll read the live print and do the bold. I'll give thanks to you, O God, with my whole heart. Before the gods, I will sing your praise.
I will bow down toward your holy temple and praise your name because of your love and faithfulness.
For you have glorified your name and your word above all things.
When I called, you answered me. You increase my strength within me.
All the kings of the earth will praise you, O God, when they have heard the words of your mouth.
They will sing of the ways of God, that great is the glory of the Most High.
Though you are high, you care for the lowly. Receive the naughty from afar, the haughty from afar.
Though I walk in the midst of trouble, you keep me safe. You stretch forth your hand against the fury of my enemies. Your right hand shall save me.
You'll make good your purpose for me. Your love endures forever. Do not abandon the works of your hands.
Glory to God, our Creator, to God's most holy word, and to the Spirit indwelling, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Please stand as you are able for the gospel. We'll be singing in Xhosa with help from our friends. At Amen Siya Kudumisa. Father, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come,
Give us each day our daily bread. And forgive us our sins as we forgive everyone indebted to us. And do not bring us to the time of trial. And he said to them, suppose one of you has a friend, and you go to him at midnight and say to him, friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread. For a friend of mine has arrived, and I have nothing to set before him. And he answers from within, do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot give up and give you anything. I tell you, even though he will not get up and give him anything because he is his friend, at least because of his persistence, he will get up and give him whatever he needs. So I say to you, ask, and it will be given to you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds. And for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you who, if your child asks for a fish, will give a snake instead of a fish? Or if the child asks for an egg, will give a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Back. It's always good to go away and have new voices and new people enter into your lives and to mine, but it is always so good to come home and see familiar faces and to hear the familiar words. I went to the United States for the first time in 3 or 4 years. I was in Boston. And I have to tell you, it's a strange place. It's a stranger than usual. My parents are from the States, so I say this with fondness. But it felt very fraught and very anxious. And I'm sure you feel that way too if you follow the news or hear what's going on. I know Nikki and Leroy, didn't you live in Michigan for a while, was it? Yeah. The pandemic, of course, has changed everything, made everything more complicated. And gun violence seems to never end. And there is this general fear in the air that I sensed, and I don't know if it was there or it just I knew it was there, so I noticed it. Now I went somewhere which was an oasis of peace. It was an oasis of prayer. And it felt good, especially good, to be with the brothers of the Society of the St. John the Evangelist in Boston on the Harvard campus. And to be with those holy men for one whole week and to pray with them. That was sort of part one of my time away. Part two, I was with my writing mentor and a group of writers who I've been working with, and it was very different there, with argument and debate and conversation and questioning and kind of pulling apart of ideas. And it was a different way of being with what is going on in the world. So there was prayer, and then there was argument and debate. And as I had those two experiences, quite different, I was left thinking as I flew home, what is going to help us? What is going to help us, not just in the States, but in the whole world? Or if that fraught and anxious feeling is especially sharp there, it is also here, and even more in places where there is greater conflict and strife. So in the end, I think both. As a good Anglican, we don't park our brains at the door. We bring our brains in, and we are allowed to argue and debate and question with one another, holding love at the center, about what we believe and what we are going to do about what we believe, what we are going to do once we have said yes to this God. If you listened to the collect or the prayer that was appointed for this day, God of the prophets, whose word cuts through the web of power and holds the tyrant to account, be with all who raise their voices against oppression and misrule, who are imprisoned and abused for freedom's sake. Help us to stand and speak with them and be witnesses to your kingdom now. So I think that prayer, which also enters into a debate and an argument about justice and right living, that both those things are going to help us. Now, did you hear, as Martha was reading the gospel, the echo or the foundation of our foundational prayer? A little bit different, words that aren't quite the same, but I'm sure you heard them and thought, I know those words, I've heard them before. Father, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, give us our daily bread, forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Recognize those words? Do you say them often? Perhaps you say them every day. These are, of course, the foundational words of our foundational prayer. I learned it as a young atheist in grade one, the Lord's Prayer. They were still teaching it in school. They're not doing that anymore. But I learned those prayers, and I learned them in the old way, and you probably did too, and you probably secretly say them in your head. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Sometimes it just, those words that were settled in early come out. I heard from our friend, Richard Leggett, who's the priest at Holy Trinity down the road. He was my professor of liturgy when I was at school, and he told us a story about once when he went on retreat, when he went away like I did, and was blessed to be with the Archbishop of Canterbury, Robert Runcie, a wonderful progressive Archbishop of Canterbury. Leading the retreat, Archbishop Runcie said the words, "Our Father," then he closed his books and went away. And he said, "That's all I have to say to you this day. Go and reflect on those two words." I was thinking about that as I was praying and preparing this week. What about if we just said those two words and I sat down and we sat in silence for 15 minutes? What would that feel like? We'd all be a bit worried that something had gone wrong. But what if you really, I invite you at 2 o'clock this morning when you wake, or tomorrow when you wake up and think, oh, I can't sleep. What if you just say those words to yourself, to your heart? What does it mean to call God our Father? Now, I don't know if you had a good father or a stinky father or a father father who is present or a father who is absent. This is a different Father. This is our Father, the creator of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I couldn't help it. I was waiting for any excuse, so I put on the front of the bulletin this week a picture from the Webb telescope. One of those many pictures, I'm sure you've seen them over the past few weeks, that looks not only deep into the universe, but deep into time, because we know that light travels to us through time and arrives in our eyes long after it left where it came from. So when we look at these pictures, we're looking far away and far, long time ago at the same time. So if you can imagine looking at light from 13 billion years ago, then perhaps you can begin to wrap your head around the idea of God as the creator of heaven and earth. Now, while I was with my writers in Boston, we had dinner with the young 24-year-old son of my mentor, and he was grilling me about my belief, because, of course, he doesn't have belief. So he said, "So do you believe in God?" And I had to answer him several times, "That's not the right question. It's not like, do I believe in Santa Claus or the Tooth Fairy or the Easter Bunny or something like that. It's not about believing or not believing. It's about expanding your heart and your imagination and your mind and your spirit to hold this greatness of God. God is not a grouchy old man in the sky with a beard who's telling us what to do and checking our list, his list, to see if we've been naughty or nice. God is the creator of everything. And this is the part that strikes us in the heart, or should if we're awake at all. God is also our Father. And as God cares for the sparrow, God cares for you and 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 everyone and everything on earth. So with the brothers, we prayed four times a day. And every single time, no matter if it was evening prayer, compline, morning prayer, noon prayer, or Holy Eucharist, we said the Lord's Prayer. So at least four times a day, I was saying and drawing into my heart the idea that God is our Holy Father. Now, if you were here at our drop-in, our St. Barnabas Cafe, on the Saturday before I went away, you know I was making a rosary. Remember? I think Jill remembers. I have bad news. It was in my pants and I washed it. So I have to start again because it's made of sari material, of cloth wrapped around a wooden bead. And as soon as the glue hit the water, it disintegrated. But then, it took me days to make this thing. But it made me laugh when I saw it coming out of the laundry, because I realized that I had done it again. It's not the first rosary I've washed or ruined. But it is a tool that I will remake and reuse to help me enter into that holy place, to enter into the words of prayer that come from so long ago, from the words of our holy teacher, Jesus, who was God, who came to earth to teach us how to be and what to do. And these things matter. They mattered then, they matter now. And we are the custodians of these words for our children, and our grandchildren. We pray together, your kingdom come. We fervently pray for the coming of peace into this troubled world. We pray for daily bread. We pray for the end of hunger, the end of using food and grain as a weapon. We pray for forgiveness, for that which we have done wrong, and that which has been done wrong to us. We pray for safety for ourselves. We pray for God to take action in the whole world, that God's kingdom, that God's power and God's glory may reign this day and forevermore. Paired with this foundation of the prayer of the Lord's Prayer this morning, we hear about God as a hospitable friend. How could it be that you, needing bread, would knock on a door and your friend would turn you away? That is not possible in God's world. Ask, search, and knock. Whatever you are living through this day, you are invited to take these actions and to know that your life, rooted in the life of God who came here to teach us the way to love, will bring fruit for yourselves and those you love. So, beloved friends, may your lives be filled with prayer, and also with questioning and wondering and debate. May you find answers filled with richness and filled with promise. And above all, may you pray with me every day for the breaking in of God's kingdom of love, so the whole world can see that we are walking in this holy path, and we are walking this way together. Thanks be to God. Stand with me as you are able, and let us say together the affirmation of the resurrection. Let us declare our faith in God.
We believe in God, the source of all life and love, from whom every family in heaven and earth is named. We believe in God, the eternal word of redemption, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with steadfast love. We believe in God, the Spirit of wisdom and truth, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Now please stand, sit, or kneel as is your custom, for the prayers of the people.
running, I say, oh God, please respond to hear our prayer. So, oh God,
hear our prayer.
I'm going to use the home verse, the order of the Mass. Loving God, we thank you for the many gifts to us, for the love which brings us together, the earth which provides for our needs, and for the new life you have given us in Jesus Christ. And so let us share prayers either aloud or silently. Beautiful day today, and for yesterday, and for coffee time out of the courtyard yesterday, and for the sacred circle on sacred singing circle on Friday. For our Christian family throughout the world. We pray for our Christian family here. And we pray for all families, for all lives. And in the end, it comes up in a prayer. We announce to pray for the Episcopal Church in Southwest Virginia. In our diocese, we are announced to pray for St. Anne's in Steveston, the Forever Lionel Patterson. And we pray for ministry in that place and for all who minister there. And we pray for the ministry of the Diocesan Refuge Union. And we pray for Shannon Weaver, Chair. And for Shikutama Sudan and Jabril Mohammed, Diocesan Refugee Administrators. And we pray for all those who have opened their doors to refugees in their diocese. We pray for the 127 Housing Society and for all those who live in their own places and make their homes there. And we pray for the work of Julian Sabell, who's president, and we will all support this ministry. And here at St. Barnabas, in our prayer cycle for all who are members, we pray for Debbie, Kyle, Shyla, for Alan and Peter. And we pray for our neighborhood. And so we pray for grace to grow in your love. Oh God,
hear our prayer.
We pray to you for our world, for all its cares and needs, and for all those who need us and care for us. And so let us pray for the world, and to fill up any special places that we need. Prayers for them. Oh God,
hear our prayer.
Our We pray to you for those in need, for the sick, the hurt, the frightened, and for those who live without. So today we've been asked to pray for strength and for healing for Liz, Mary, Ed. Please raise up any prayers. We can do prayers at this time. Oh God, hear our prayer. We pray for those we love who have died, that you will surround them with your care and love, and comfort those who mourn. And let us remember those who are special in our lives who have passed. Oh God,
hear our prayer.
We pray for one another, asking you to bless us, our friends, our family, our relatives, and those who we call family. Bless the places where we work, bless our homes, and bless our lives. Oh God, may you reign of love, peace, justice, and mercy. Come, and we lift up all our prayers into God's loving embrace.
Words of the confession and absolution. Happy are those whose sins are forgiven, whose wrongs are pardoned. I will confess my sins to the Lord. I will not conceal my wrongdoings. God forgives and heals us.
We need your healing, merciful God. Give us true repentance. Some sins are plain to us. Some escape us. Some we cannot face. Forgive us. Set us free to hear your word to us. Set us free to serve you.
God forgives you. Forgive others and forgive yourself. Please stand as you are able. Beloved ones in Christ, may the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's share a sign of that peace with one another. Our offertory hymn is number 62, Come, Let Us Eat.
There's Jeremy. Yay!
Come, let us eat.
be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Eternal God, source of all being, we give you thanks and praise for your faithful love. You call us into friendship with you and one another. To be with you, a sign of your presence in the world. When those we trust betray us, unfailingly you remain with us. When we injure others, you confront us in your love and call us to the path of righteousness. You stand with the weak and those broken and alone, whom you have always welcomed home, making the first last and the last first. Therefore, we raise our voices with angels and archangels, forever praising you and singing. Loving and Holy One, recalling Christ's death and resurrection, we offer you these gifts, longing for the bread of tomorrow and the wine of the age to come. Therefore, we proclaim our hope. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. Pour out your Spirit on these gifts, that through them you may sustain us in our hunger for your peace. We hold before you all whose lives are marked by suffering, our sisters and our brothers. When we are broken and cast aside, embrace us in your love.
Restore us, O God, let your face shine.
Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, O source of life, now and forever. Now, as our Savior taught us, let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
We in him
our one body, for we all share in the one bread. These are the gifts of God, and we are the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
So as we have been doing for a while now, we will invite you to come forward and receive bread and wine if you wish. You don't have to receive either. If you like a blessing, if you ask for a blessing, if you prefer just the bread, that's fine as well. And we will start on this side with Sahya and then move from right to left. Have a good few look.
Thank you.
Stand as you are able. Let us say together the prayer after communion. Living God, in this sacrament we have shared in your eternal kingdom, may we who taste this mystery forever serve you in faith, hope, and love. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the Church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. So, community announcements, you can see on the back of the bulletin everything that's going on this week. We are full swing into our neighborhood ministries. The Grab and Go grocery program is on Wednesday from 1 to 3. The family drop-in, we're still carrying on. I think we'll do one more Thursday before just closing down for the summer. That's Thursday from 10 to 12. And we've been very excited to have the Love and Listen St. Barnabas Community Cafe on Saturday afternoon from 2 to 4. So drop in and make some new friends or say hi to old friends. I do have some news. Am I allowed to share? I have some terrible news. Terrible, sad, awful, heartbreaking, dreadful news, which is actually wonderful news. Roland, our beloved member of church committee, has been offered a job in Calgary. I was gonna give him a terrible reference and say, oh no, we don't want Roland in your business, but I didn't have the heart to do it. So Roland will be with us. Will you be here next Sunday? So we're gonna have a big lunch next Sunday to thank Roland for his years of loving presence with us here. And we're all coming to visit you in Calgary, so you rent it or buy a big house where we all fit, right? We're going on a road trip to Calgary, and it's not that far away. We are heartbroken, but we're delighted that your career will be taking a step forward. We look forward to a forever friendship with you. So, yay, Roland! Yay! We'll miss his leading our prayers. We're hoping he will lead prayers one last time. And I think, was it Martha, you suggested that Roland should write a book of his prayers? You need to write a book of prayers. Roland has prayers like no one else. So we may call you in Calgary once in a while. Can you zoom in and do prayers with us? So I hope you can come next week. It's the long weekend, but hopefully we'll be here. It's a strange long weekend because the 1st of August lands on the Monday. So it's the earliest, I think, that the long weekend can ever be. So please come next week and help us sing Roland off into his next adventures. Anything else I'm forgetting? No? Usually forget something, but not this week. Okay, welcome if you're new here, if it's your first time in a while, and we'll be having coffee and tea in the courtyard. I saw a table set up, and I think Maureen has disappeared, which is always a good sign. There is a sign-up sheet if you want to help with the coffee time after church. So it's usually Maureen and Chris has been helping a lot, and others have signed up. So if you have a space to either help set up or bring a goodie or two or help do the dishes, there's still lots of space to help out with that ministry. It's a ministry of love to our neighbors. Can I say how wonderful it is to have these babies? Oh no, somebody came home with a new baby. Hi, Shannon. They always just gurgle it, right at the right time. So wonderful to have them. So, beloved ones in Christ, the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and in the love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Mother, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you now and remain with you always. Amen. Our sending hymn is number 259-259, For the Fruit of All Creation. A good song for the summer.
Rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Thanks be to God.